We have live team coverage of the effort to rebuild local communities 1 week after the devastating tornadoes. Lexi Sheen is live in Marysville, where Lowe's employees are helping in the cleanup efforts. But we begin with Eric King, live in Henryville, with a look at the process being made there. Eric?
It's clear. It is clear as the day is bright right now, the progress that's being made. And there's something soul-stirring, I have to say, about the heart of a volunteer. And you can find them all over the place. Most notably, this morning, the Colts rolled in from Indianapolis. Tarps and coolers, things that people here have been asking for over the past number of days. You can see that field behind me. They've actually done a lot of clearing in that. And that's just part of the noticeable work that's been done over the course of the week.
The snow and the wind and the rain and everything else, and it's like, okay, God, when is it going to stop? It stopped. Thank you, Lord.
It's been a long week, but after taking one of nature's heaviest blows, Henryville is doing more than just getting by. It's achieving.
I noticed that the Shell station looks like it's starting to get operational again, and phone service, some of it is starting to be restored a little bit.
You know, I'll be honest with you, it took me a while to decide where to even start, because where do you start when you've got so much? But then I realized the reality is you can see signs of recovery all over the place. If you just look at this to the naked eye, it looks like a disaster area. But then you realize that all of this was all over the yard, and it's at least been brought up front. It's been a lot of work to get it there, so that's certainly a good sign. Traffic is starting to pick up back on the main roadway to get into the street. That's another good thing. If you go across the street, you've got mobile mission units from all over the country that are showing up just to do whatever they can to help out. But there are reminders of what's been lost.
Yesterday I was down here for a funeral, for Wayne's funeral, which was a packed house. Really well-loved guy.
William Wayne Hunter was laid to rest Thursday in Henryville, 2 days before his 63rd birthday. His obituary reads, "I'd like the memory of me to be a happy one."
When you look at all the carnage around here and you think, you know, I don't want to say only one death, because he was very precious.
Electricity is sporadic and water is scarce. That is, though, an improvement on days ago when there was neither. Here's some more good news for you. The power lines are up. As you'll remember, a few days ago, they were sprawling about on the ground. Some damage, though, is going to take a lot longer to fix than others. This house obviously taking a lot of damage, but the good news here is it's still standing. Still standing. It could easily be the town's new motto.
It's been amazing. The thing that has impressed me the most is everybody working together, all the churches.
What better example of that than right here? This church group just pulled up behind us within the past 10 minutes. Couldn't even tell you where they're from. Haven't had a chance to talk to them because, frankly, they just got here. Again, back out here, live on the ground in Henryville. The last thing I'll show you is the school. It's a disaster area. That's what it's been called all week long, but there are signs that that's no longer the case. You can hear construction equipment behind me. This fence is here, turning this officially from a disaster area into a construction zone. So the signs of progress are all around. All you have to do is open your eyes. Live in Henryville, I'm Eric King, WLKY News.